It was so culture shifting in so many different ways, you know. But yet and still, you guys were continually snubbed by the Emmys. So let's talk a little bit about that. You know, 50's been, you know, we had that talk in L.A., remember,
yeah,
and 50
and
went off.
Yeah.
Yeah, and then, you know, 50's been doing press and talking about it as well. What do you think about it? Like, does that bother you that the show was so seminal and so culture shaping and shifting, and yet it was snubbed?
It never... I guess bothered would be dramatic if I was speaking about it, Bevy, in terms of just walking down the street as a person in my feelings.
Mm-hmm.
I wasn't bothered.
Okay.
As a person walking down the street in my feelings, like every other person walking down the street in their feelings, thinking more from a business standpoint, mm-hmm. it started to bother me.
Yes.
But my personality is not one to get, I've been through too much in life.
Yeah.
There's been too much to be bothered by that.
Mm-hmm.
But from a business standpoint, I started to understand that my colleagues,
mm-hmm.
The Johnny Bernthals,
mm-hmm.
who don't look like me,
yep.
but have the gift of Omari.
Yep.
You know, I look at a Tom Hardy, a John Bernthal, like mm-hmm. at 40 plus years of age, Bevy, it would be dangerous for myself, for your relationship with me, for my publicist,
mm-hmm.
and for my family if I didn't know how gifted I was. That's
right.
a problem.
Yeah, exactly.
So I understand my gift. And when I look at those that equal my gift, that don't look like me, I'm aware that if John Bernthal plays Ghost, he's Emmy nominated.
Yeah.
That's the best way for me to say it.
Yeah.
Because I wanted to start it out by going, John Bernthal is one of my best friends in the industry.
Yeah.
A brilliant kid who's from D.C. and a hell of a fucking actor. But if you think about him in this role, Bevy, you wouldn't be having to ask him the same question. And I'm aware of that. So I get why 50, you know, said what he said. But I don't mind breaking it down further to say, hey, all you have to do is line up the people that are equal to an Omari talent.
Mm-hmm.
And all you have to do is line up the shows that are equal to the talent of that which Courtney and Curtis created with Stars as an umbrella. And Courtney and Curtis, if they perhaps look a different way, they're nominated 4 or 5 times for this show.
Right. Yeah.
It can't ever just be something that frustrates me from a standpoint of being, you know, an actor on the show.
Right.
Because in reality, I'm so about team and I'm a middle kid and mm-hmm. I'll never lose the middle kid. So.
Yeah.
I find myself in the middle of it going, we should have been nominated.
Yeah.
Joseph always says, which is speaking to our real bromance, not as Ghost and Tommy, but as Joseph and Omari. He says, I just wish at least Omari got nominated because his business moves could have been easier.
Yes.
Had he been. And for him to say that, I never thought about that.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I thought about it once he said it. And so that guy walking down the street, meaning myself at that point, I thought, like Joe, I was like, oh, yeah, business-wise, it'd have been a lot easier to navigate.
This is called show business.
That's it.
You know what I mean?
And it should be called business show.
Exactly. The business of the show
That's
right
it.
There.
That's really what it should be called.